Hi, I'm Dr. Ajaz from Kerr. I'm here to share an interesting case of elongated styloid process. Patient is a 49-year-old male, was referred to us by a neurologist. He gives history of a CVA 1 year back, after which he developed a right hemiparesis and atresia, now cured completely and on antiplatelet drug. This is a then taken CT angiography of the patient showing carotid dissection on the left side by the elongated styloid process. A left styloidectomy was planned after stopping all the antiplatelet drugs. Here patient is intubated and kept in Ross's position, and a tonsillectomy is being done on the left side with the use of a coblator EVAC 7D band. Bloodless field in adult tonsillectomy is not always possible, as the loose areolar tissue separating the tonsil and the superior constrictive muscle will be fibrosed. Here we slowly separate the tonsil from its bed without injury to the underlying muscle. So after tonsillectomy, we are proceeding to identify the elongated styloid bone. Now the styloid bone identified and fixed here using a Frias elevator, and the superficial muscle is being coagulated initially to avoid any blood in the field. Now the muscle over the styloid bone is being separated using the coablation mode to expose the styloid bone underneath. You can see the styloid bone is being slowly visualized. The muscle being separated furthermore to completely expose the styloid bone. Coablation is also used over the styloid bone to ablate the tissues over it and separate it from the bone. After separation of the muscle and tissues lateral to the bone, attachments to the tip of the styloid bone is also being separated. Here we are using a Mitchell's trimmer attachments medial to the styloid bone is also separated using the same instrument. Additionally, we used a wriggly board used for ear surgeries to expose more of the styloid bone. After completely exposing the styloid bone, separating all the tissues attached to it all around, a ring curette is passed through the tip of the bone and pushed to its base so as to expose maximum bone and to separate tissues around it. And also it stabilizes while fracturing the bone. Here we are using a Lux forceps after stabilizing to fracture the bone without injuring adjacent muscles and vessels. The defect in the muscle is sutured using a 3-0 Vicryl just to avoid any infections in post-op into the parapharyngeal space. Here is a picture of the specimen, and this is on the 7th post-op day, the cavity. Thank you.